Neophyte hybrids are third and fourth generation gene stealers that form the vast majority of the gene stealer cult, and when the uprising happens, they overwhelm their enemies with sheer weight of numbers. In this video, we're going to show you how to paint one in the colour scheme of the cult of the Rusted Claw, and this is the orange colour scheme that you see an awful lot of inside the gene stealer cult codex. So, without further ado, let's get started. Normally for a miniature like this, I'd start with an undercoat of Chaos Black Spray, but in this case, I've actually instead gone for Mechanicus Standard Grey instead. Now the reason for this is because a lot of this miniature is going to be grey anyway, so this is an ideal starting point for that colour in particular, but it's also a great undercoat for all the other colours we're going to use as well, so I recommend you do the same. Now the first colour we're going to use is Jacquero Orange, and this is for all the orange robes. Now as always, give all your paints a good shake before you use each colour, and I'm going to be applying this using a small base brush because it will give me a lot of control to get to all the detail that I want. Now, I always recommend that you use a palette with your paints because it gives you a lot of control as to what exactly you're doing with the paint. So put some paint on there, and it means that you can add a small amount of water to the mix. You don't need loads, but doing so just ensures your paint goes a bit further and also dries smoother as well. Now, make sure you don't have too much paint in your brush so you've got lots of control, and when you're ready, all you've got to do is start picking out all the robes. So the kind of detail we're looking at is such as just down here like this. Now, you will need to apply two thin coats, just like the first one dry before you move on to the second one, and just be neat when you're getting close to any parts that are later going to be grey. So the bits I mean by that are these rubber panels and also the armour that's up around the shoulders as well. Once you've finished picking out all the orange parts, the next colour we need is going to be a Baden Black for doing all the black components. And by this we're looking at things like leather, cables, all that kind of thing. Now I'm once again going to be using my small base brush to apply this, and as before, make use of your palette to get the paint under control. So get a good amount on there, then add a small amount of water into the mix so it's nice and smooth, and when you're ready, all you've got to do is start looking for all these black details to pick them out. Now I'm going to start on the boots down here, and these details will vary slightly from miniature to miniature, just depending on how you built your hybrids, but in all cases, you want a good solid coat, so I do recommend applying two thin coats before you move on. Once you've finished painting all those black components, we're ready to just add a few more base coats to the miniature before we start adding some shade. And the first of these is going to be Administratum Grey for all the armour and also all the rubber panels. Then we're going to add some Lead Belcher for all the parts that you want to be silver. Then we're going to pick out some parts with Brass Scorpion for parts that, well, you want to be brass. But first of all, Administratum Grey, I'm going to use my medium layer brush this time. And what you're looking to do here is, like I say, paint all the armour and also all the rubber panels as well. So make sure you've got lots of control over your paint when it's nicely thinned down on your palette before you start applying it. And when you're ready, all you've got to do is start painting all these components. So I'm going to start just here where you can see there's quite a lot of stuff that we want to be this lighter grey colour. Start applying it as smoothly as you can, and once again I do recommend two thin coats to get it especially smooth on flatter panels, just on the shoulder just here. The next colour to apply is Lead Belcher, and this is for any metallic details that you want. So I'm going to start out by applying this all over the shotgun. And then pick out any parts that you want to be brass using Brass Scorpion. Now that we've base coated all those colours, we're ready to add some shade to the miniature. And all the colours we've done so far can actually be shaded all at the same time using Agrax Earthshade. So we're going to go for that, applied with a medium shade brush. And what you want to do here is get plenty of this on your palette. You want a good puddle of it to draw the paint from to give you control over exactly how much you're applying. But we do want to put on quite a lot at once, so get a good puddle there. And when you're ready and you've got some loaded up on your brush, all you're looking to do is to paint this entirely over your miniature. So as you apply it, you're looking to work it into all the details as you go, and just be aware that when you're putting on this much shade, it does have a tendency to run towards the bottom of the miniature and collect there. So as it's drying, just keep an eye on it, and if you do see any of this pooling, just move away the excess paint before it dries. Now it will take about an hour to dry, but it's important that it's completely dry before you start onto the next stage. Once that shade's fully dry, we're now ready to move on to the next feature of the miniature, which is going to be the skin. And to do this, we're going to paint it completely to give it a purple tint. So we're going to start out with a base coat of Bugman's Glow, then we'll shade all over it with Druhy Violet. Then we'll add a layer of Cadian Flesh Tone before finishing off with a highlight of Kislev Flesh. So then starting out with Bugman's Glow, I'm going to go for my small base brush, and as always, put it on your palette and thin it down with some water so the paint's nice and smooth. And when you're ready, you just need to base coat all of the skin. The amount of skin that's visible will really vary depending on how exactly you built your hybrids, but for our miniature here, we're just looking at the head, so I'm just going to base coat all around here, being careful as we get close to colours that we've painted so far. Then shade all over the skin with Druhy Violet. Now you don't need loads of this shade, so I do recommend applying it with a medium layer brush. Once that shade's completely dry, we're now ready to add a layer of Cadian flesh tone to the skin. For this, what you want to do is follow all the major features and avoid any recessed details where shade has settled the most. So for example, around the face here, I'm mainly following the bone structure, things like the cheekbones, the eyes, brows, areas like this kind of thing. But when you get to the top of the head, what you want to do is just follow those ridges across the forehead there like that. As you get further up, just apply a smooth coat all over the top of the head there like that. And then finish off the skin with a highlight of Kisler flesh, once again following along all the areas of bone structure. So things like the cheekbones, the brows, all this kind of thing. And with that, the skin is complete. Now you'll notice in the codex, a lot of these miniatures have red markings on them to denote squads. So we're just going to show you now how you can start out doing that. The colour you need for it is corn red, and I'm going to be applying this with my small layer brush, because when you're doing freehand markings like this, you want as much control over the paint as possible. So a fine brush like this is a very good idea. Also, thin it down with a little bit more water than you normally would to make sure the paint is a little bit runnier, so you have more control over it. And make sure you don't have too much on your brush, and when you're ready, you just need to decide where you want these markings to be. I'm going to apply onto this shoulder just here, and I'm going to start out by painting a vertical line down the middle of it there like that. So just orient the model so I can do this nice and neatly, and then from there, just gradually widen that line out either side there like that. Now, also on this particular miniature, I've got a shotgun, so on this, I need to paint the shotgun shells too. So once again, I'm just going to base coat these using corn red. Now that red marking's been applied, we're ready to add some layers to some colours just to brighten them back up before we start adding some highlights. So we're going to do this on the orange parts using Trollslayer Orange, and on the grey armour with Administratum Grey once again. But Trollslayer Orange, first of all, I'm going to use my small airbrush for applying this, because this time we want to be much more selective about where exactly we paint the orange than we were previously. So, sure thing, your paints, I want a thin coat here, and when you're ready, what you're looking to do is to apply this onto the orange robes, but avoid the areas where shade has settled from previously. So, for example, just around here, I'm looking at applying a thin coat to this flatter area just here, but then where that shade settled just to the side of it there, I'm just going to avoid that part and pick it up again on the other side. And once you finish doing that to the orange robes, the next colour you need is Administratum Grey to apply a layer to all the armour. And once again, you want to avoid all the recessed areas where shade has settled to keep that definition showing. And there we go. With those layers applied, we're now ready to move on to our final highlights to complete the miniature. So we're going to start out with Fire Dragon Bright to highlight all the orange robes, and then we're going to use Pallid Witch Flesh to highlight all the grey armour and rubber panels. Then we'll use Evilson Scarlet to highlight the small amounts of red we've got, and then Dawnstone for all the darker grey clothing that's still showing through. Then we'll use Eschen Grey to highlight all the black parts, and we'll finish off with Stormhost Silver to highlight all our metallic components. So first of all then, Fire Dragon Bright back with a small layer brush, and what we're looking to do this time is just to pick out the sharpest creases of the fabric. So you really don't need very much of this. Be sure as always that you thin your paint down so it's flowing really smoothly, and once you've got your mix ready, what you're looking to do is to find all those creases on the fabric. So for example, on the back here, the kind of thing I'm looking for is things like this sharp line we've got just running down here. I'm just going to follow that all the way down there like that. Also these little tears that we've got in the fabric too, and be sure to follow along the hem along the bottom of the robe as well. Next, highlight all the light grey parts using Pallid Witch Flesh. So you're looking for an edge highlight here, following along all the corners and sharper details. And on these ridged panels we've got for the rubber parts here, just lightly run your brush along them, just catch those raised details there like that, really quickly. Now if your hybrid has an open mouth, be sure to paint the teeth at this stage as well. The next area to highlight are all the red parts, and for this you just need to add an edge highlight of Evil Sun Scarlet. The next colour to apply is Dawnstone, and this is to highlight any of the darker fabric beneath the orange fabric. And once again, you're just looking to paint a line of this, following any of the more prominent creases. The next colour to apply is Eschen Grey, and this is to highlight all of the black components around the miniature. And then the final colour to apply is Stormhost Silver, and this is to highlight all of your metallic details. And once done this, you're ready to base your miniature. And as always, I recommend you base it in the same way as the rest of your army. Now the base is fully painted, this Neophyte Hybrid is complete and ready to go and join his brothers in overwhelming the host planet's defenders by sheer weight of numbers. So when you're painting this model, the important things to remember are, as you apply your colours to it, always remember to apply them as multiple thin layers, because if you do, you'll get a nice smooth finish on the colour, and you also build a really strong colour as well. And when you apply the all-over shade, keep an eye on it as it dries, because it can have a tendency to pull towards the bottom of the model, and if it does this, just move away that excess paint with your brush before it dries. And finally, when you're applying your highlights, always remember to be as neat as you possibly can, because the neater you are, the better it's going to look. Now, if you're painting the Cult of the Rusted Claw, remember you can apply what we've shown in this video to paint just about anything in the Genestealer Cult range. So have fun as you're painting your miniatures, and we'll see you again very soon. If you enjoyed that video and you'd like to see more, then why not subscribe to Warhammer TV? It's crammed with content, including loads of other tutorials. And in fact, if you'd like to watch another tutorial right now, why not click one of the links below?